بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. The eve of the 15th of Sha'ban is referred to in narrations as the greatest night of the year after the night of Qadr. It's such a blessed night full of forgiveness from the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to be missed. Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam states in a narration that it's a night so amazing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it incumbent upon himself not to turn away anyone asking for needs, except if they're asking for an act of disobedience. Of course, it's the eve of the anniversary of the birth of the hope for mankind, the representative of Allah on this earth, the 12th holy Imam, Imam al-Mahdi, may Allah hasten his reappearance. Exactly 1,187 years ago, the great grandson of the Holy Prophet was born in Samarra and remains alive miraculously till today. Yes, the day of the 15th is a great day of celebration, but in Islam, the best way to celebrate is to remember the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala in devotion and indeed worship. So here are seven important things we should seek to do on the eve of the 15th of Sha'ban. Number one, to facilitate cleansing of the soul, we should cleanse our bodies too. Hence, it's recommended to perform ghusl, washing of the body, seeking to remove the impurities within our hearts as well. Did you know that a dua many of us recite on Thursday nights started in a night like this? Kumail ibn Ziyad said, I was with Imam Ali alayhi salam in Masjid al-Basra on the eve of 15th of Sha'ban, where the Imam said, I swear by Allah the Almighty, tonight is when every definitive matter is resolved. Chapter 44, verse number 4. For the year, I followed him to his house and he taught me a dua, which I should recite tonight and every Thursday night. That's right, it's the night that dua Kumail was given to us. So we should read it in our own language if necessary, and try to reflect upon its beautiful words. Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam has a deep connection with his grandfather Imam al-Husayn, peace be upon him, as well as the principles of the 10th of Muharram. It's highly recommended on a night like this to recite the ziyarah of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, either by reciting the recommended ziyarah found in books like Mafatih al-Jinan, or just saying, Assalamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah. As-salamu alayka wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Afterwards, don't forget to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to live by his teachings and to get the opportunity to visit his sacred shrine. Number four, this is the night to stay up as much as possible for Quran, dua, dhikr and salah. It's the night to seek genuine tawbah, forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a beautiful narration that highlights the greatness of the eve of the 15th of Sha'ban. The Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam said, Jibra'il came to me on one night and said, it's the eve of the 15th of Sha'ban, so let us go to the Baqi' cemetery. Once there he said, raise your head. This is the night that the doors of heaven open up. Also, when mercy, forgiveness, blessings, virtue and generosity are given abundantly. So anyone who stays up performing remembrance of Allah through dua, salah, Quran and istighfar, Allah will forgive all their sins and paradise is indeed for them. There is no angel in the heavens that is not worshipping tonight. Whatever anyone asks God, he will give them. Whatever pardon they seek, he will forgive them. A special salah narrated from Imam Sadiq alayhi salam on such a night is as follows. After Salatul Isha, we perform a two-unit Ruk'atayn Salah. In the first Ruk'ah after Surah Al-Fatiha, we recite Surah Al-Kafirun, chapter 109. And in the second, after Fatiha, we recite Surah Al-Ikhlas, Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad. Upon finishing this, we recite Subhanallah 33 times, Alhamdulillah 33 times, and Allahu Akbar 34 times. Then a dua is recited, which is found under this video, followed by some dhikr in sujood, also mentioned in the link. Then we recite the salawat and we ask for our needs, which will be inshallah fulfilled by the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number six, speak to the Imam of our time from your heart. Connect with him by reciting some amazing du'as like dua al-faraj, dua al-ahd, and some recommended du'as on a night like this. The link is also found below. Make sure to understand what you're saying and tell him how you feel. Let the tears flow. give sadaqah on his behalf. Start a good project tonight and dedicate some good deeds to him. Pray for the hastening of his reappearance and the opportunity to meet and indeed serve him. Number 7, don't forget, it's also highly recommended to fast on the day of the 15th of Sha'ban to attain reward and blessings from the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Congratulations to all of you on this blessed occasion. Please don't forget me and my family in your prayers and du'as. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts all your deeds and devotion on such a night. Also, a kind request not to forget the oppressed around the globe, as well as all those suffering from hardship such as illness or poverty.